Buonasera a tutti noi e a tutti voi della Chiesa della Pace. Siamo Cristina Larosa e un prete nuovo nella Chiesa, Jacob Holm, prete nella Chiesa oggi, Nils O. Eriksen, il presidente del Consiglio Pastorale oggi, e Carsten Poulsen, la vecchia presidente del Consiglio Pastorale, e Leif Vestergaard, anche un vecchio prete nella Chiesa, come io mi chiamo Per Thompson, anche prete nella Chiesa. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Since the year 2000, the Church of Peace, Fredenskirken, in Aarhus Diocese in Denmark, has related to two parishes, San Donato and Corpus Christi, in Pesaro Diocese, in a binding friendship. Since then, we have followed each other in a dream and labor for that, despite differences in language, nationality, church affiliation, in ways of expression our Christian faith, we can still be united in Christ. And that we as Christians are one body and one spirit with one hope, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, and one God. In the Parish of Peace, there are more than 7,000 people, approximately 5,500 of them are members of the Church. The Church of Peace is part of the Evangelical Lutheran Church in Denmark. At the Church of Peace, there are two permanent priests, Jacob Holm and Christina Larsen, employed the 1st of January, and the theology professor, Peter Lodberg. The Church of Peace is characterized by an active congregation as well as a very lively musical life centered around many talented choirs.
Che Cristo per fede deve dimorare nei vostri cuori. That Christ, by faith, must dwell in your hearts. The little quote we just heard comes from St. Paul in his letter to the church in Ephesus, or perhaps rather to all the churches in the province of Asia. It is written while Paul was imprisoned in Rome. The epistle to Ephesians has been called the epistle to the church, because Paul speaks about the church as the body of Christ. On this body, there are many limbs that have different functions, but all functions must serve to build the body of Christ until all reach unity in faith. No other scripture in the New Testament so strongly emphasizes the church community, the church's relationship to Christ, and its significance to the individual. Only unity is the key word in this letter. Unity with God and unity between different Christian groups. The service in the congregation must always be done together in teamwork that includes both equality and diversity. On the one hand, all are equal, since all in Christ are one body and one spirit, with one hope, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God. On the other hand, there is also a difference in the device. This difference in unity works in the same way as a body, where everyone helps with the strength it has been given, so that the body grows and is built up in love. Paul is thus saying that the strength of community lies in equality and diversity. For this fellowship to unfold in equality and diversity, Paul prays for the churches that Christ by faith may dwell in our hearts. And this faith is described as love, a love that has its origin in the love of Christ. It is the love of God that must fill us, so that we can pass that love on to the other people. Paul also expresses the same message in the letter to the Galatians, where he says, "I no longer live myself, but Christ lives in me." It is also formulated in a verse in a new Danish hymn, with which I will conclude. "Then I will lay down my life in your hands. Then I know, no matter how it ends, when you grow up in me, that I am getting smaller, there is no death, and there is no need in the world that can separate us. Amen."
Let us pray. Holy Spirit, may we receive in our hearts the presence of Christ and cherish it as a secret of love. Nourish our prayer. Enlighten our readings of Scripture. Act through us, so that the fruits of your gifts can patiently grow in us. Amen.
Receive the Celtic blessing. The Lord be before you to show you the right way. The Lord be beside you to follow you on your road. The Lord be behind you to keep your back free. The Lord be under you, to grab you when you fall. The Lord be in you, to fill you with His Spirit. The Lord be around you, to keep you from evil. The Lord be upon you, to bless you. Then be blessed by God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.